Toyota issues a do not drive advisory for some of its older vehicles in the U.S. The Japanese automaker urged owners of 50,000 units of 2003 to 2004 Corollas, the Corolla Matrix, and RAV4s to stop driving their vehicles and get immediate recall repairs. This stems from an airbag inflator which could explode and potentially kill motorists. Since 2009, more than 30 deaths worldwide, including 26 in the U.S., are linked to the airbag inflators.
In Pakistan, former Prime Minister Imran Khan is sentenced to a decade behind bars for leaking state secrets. The case stems from an alleged leak of secret diplomatic correspondence that Pakistan's envoy to Washington sent to Islamabad when Khan was Prime Minister. The envoy alleged the U.S. threatened to topple Khan's government and oust him. Washington has denied these allegations. Khan is already serving a three-year jail term after being convicted of corruption. He insists all the charges against him are politically motivated.
Over now to Hong Kong, where officials begin a push to tighten the city's national security laws. Chief Executive John Lee said Tuesday they will seek the passage of tighter security measures before Hong Kong's Legislative Council. Now, this follows implementation in 2020 of a highly contentious security law from Beijing. The private sector is closely watching developments in the Chinese Special Administrative Region. The prospect of new laws targeting, among others, foreign influence is seen to have a deep impact on the global financial hub.
We do know that they'll probably adopt the broad definition of what a foreign political organization is or what a foreign agent is. It may well be that businesses or groups that have some connection with foreign governments might be captured here, and also possibly, even if it may be a kind of business enterprise or joint venture, one might have to look more carefully at the sources of the funding.
Other news now, the Philippine Armed Forces says it remains unbothered by Chinese vessels swarming the West Philippine Sea. A Navy official says over 200 Chinese ships have been spotted around Mischief Reef near Ayungin Shoal. Commodore Roy Trinidad notes their presence is not alarming, adding the AFP has also deployed enough Philippine ships to secure the country's territory. This assurance comes as the Philippines denies China's claims of a supposed temporary special agreement to allow the delivery of supplies to Philippine troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre. National Security Council spokesperson Jonathan Malaya says there is no truth to the statement, which he calls a figment of the imagination of the Chinese Coast Guard. A political analyst believes the ongoing rift between President Marcos and his predecessor Rodrigo Duterte stems from a lack of appreciation. Professor Jean Franco of the UP Political Science Department says the Dutertes believe Marcos failed to reciprocate his predecessor's order to bury the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. at the Hero Cemetery in 2016. Franco also believes the current political climate presents an opportunity for the opposition to regroup and recalibrate.
They should seize the moment in whatever way they can. They should recalibrate their forces, their strategies, and seize the moment in what's happening right now. They cannot continue with what they've been doing before, because we've seen two elections, 2019 and 2022 elections, where the opposition has practically been decimated. So they need to recalibrate, regroup, and look for better and new strategies.
Former Philippine senators chiming in on the rift between the Dutertes and President Marcos. Antonio Trillanes IV called on Vice President Sara Duterte to resign as Education Secretary of the Marcos cabinet. In a post on X, he said VP Duterte should be ashamed of the chaos that her father and brother instigated by insulting President Marcos. Lara de Lima, meanwhile, urged Marcos and former President Rodrigo Duterte to get their act together and prioritize more pressing problems. That's after Duterte claimed Marcos was in a drugs watch list. And Marcos retaliated by saying the former president's use of fentanyl has affected his behavior. De Lima believes that Dutertes are attacking Marcos to survive.
I think it's all about really survival, because they know that they're not being eased out. There's the looming ICC development in ICC that could lead to the issuance of warrant of arrest. And then, syempre, itong chacha, yung kanilang motivation is not really for the common good. It's for self-preservation.